Assalamu alaikum students. In the previous lecture, we defined a metric space. A metric space is a non-empty set with a metric defined on it. So a metric is basically a distance function which takes any two points of a metric space and calculates a kind of distance between them. And for this distance function to be a metric, it has to satisfy certain axioms. In today's lecture, we are going to talk about another concept in metric spaces, which is an open sphere or open ball and closed sphere or a closed ball. So let us first define what an open sphere or open ball is, and then we will illustrate this concept with examples. So let us consider a metric space XD. So let XD be a metric space and a point X naught belong to X and R be an element of positive real numbers, then an open sphere with center at X naught and radius R is defined as the set of all those points of the metric space X whose distance from X naught is less than R. Okay, so in order to define an open sphere or open ball, we are considering a metric space X with a metric D defined on it. We are considering a point X naught in that space and positive real number R. Then an open sphere with center at X naught is basically the set of all those points of the metric space whose distance from this X naught is less than this R. It is denoted by S R X naught. There is the open sphere with radius R and center X naught, or an open ball with center at X naught and radius R. So in order to define an open sphere or open ball inside a metric space X, we consider a point X naught inside that metric space and a positive real number R. Then the set of all those points of the metric space whose distance from this X naught is less than R, then that set of points is called an open sphere with radius R and center X naught, or an open ball with center X naught and radius R. So mathematically we can write it as, so S R X naught, so open sphere with radius R centered at X naught, or open ball centered at X naught and radius R, is basically the set of all X belonging to the metric space X such that the distance of all those x points, x values from the center x naught is less than r. So this is the definition of an open sphere or open ball inside a metric space. So now we will consider some examples of open spheres, and we will talk about the metric spaces that we have discussed in the last lecture. There is the set of real numbers is a metric space, which is a real line. Similarly, our coordinate plane, which is R2, and the discrete metric space. Okay, so first of all, we consider open sphere inside the real line. Open sphere in x is equal to r, the metric space of real numbers or real line. Now let us consider an open sphere inside the real line. So this is our real line r. So let us consider this point x naught, and now we are going to consider all the points whose distance from x naught is less than, suppose, r. So we are going to take a distance from x naught, which is r. So this is r. So we will take r on either side of x naught. So this is also r. Okay. Now all the points which lie at a distance less than r from either side of x naught will be basically this open interval from x naught. Okay. So this open interval will be the open sphere, and this point over here will be x naught plus r, and this will be x naught minus r. Okay, so this open interval x naught minus r and x naught plus r, so this open interval will be an open sphere inside the real line. So open sphere inside a real line is basically an open interval. So we can also write it in the form of a theorem, which says that in the usual metric space, which is x is equal to r, the set of real numbers or real line with metric D of xy is equal to x minus y mod an open sphere is an open interval. Open interval. Okay, so any open interval on the real line will be an open sphere. So now let us prove this thing. So let us prove that inside the real line, an open sphere is an open interval. So now we are going to consider the metric space, which is the set of real numbers or the whole real line. Let x naught be a point of the real line and r be a positive real number. Then an open sphere with radius r centered at x naught by definition will be equal to the set of all x belonging to r such that the distance of x from x naught is less than r. Okay. So now we are going to write this distance. We know that the metric defined on real numbers is d of xy is equal to x minus y mod. So we can write it as set of all x belonging to r such that if we apply this metric, this distance formula over here. So we get x minus x naught mod is less than r. So we can write it as instead of all x belonging to r side that if we expand this mod, so we can write it as minus r is less than x minus x naught, which is less than r. Okay. And if we add x naught throughout this inequality, so we get x naught minus r is less than x is less than x naught plus r. So now you can see that our open sphere with radius r centered at x naught is the set of all those points which are greater than x naught minus r and less than x naught plus r. So which is an open interval x naught minus r, x naught plus r, open interval. So we have proved that. So we have proved that an open sphere inside the real line is basically an open interval. So now we will consider some other examples of open spheres inside this real line. Okay, now let us consider on the real line that our point suppose x naught is, other examples, that our x naught is suppose 1. Okay, so on the real line, so this is 1, so this is x naught, this is center of the sphere. Let us take radius as 1/2. Okay, so what will be the open sphere now on this real line with this center and this radius? So as we have already seen that the open sphere on the real line will be x naught minus r and x naught plus r. So this open interval will be the open sphere on this real line. So now calculate this open interval from these two values. So it will be, so 1 minus 1/2 and 1 plus 1/2. So which is 1/2, 3/2. So this open interval is the open sphere. So this is our open sphere with radius 1/2 and center 1. So now let us consider another example of an open sphere inside the real line. So now, but this time we are going to consider the metric space which is not the whole real line, but it is a subset of real line. So we are considering a metric space X which is the set of all the points from 1 to 2, this closed interval, the set of all the points in between 1 and 2, including 1 and 2. So because every non-empty subset of a metric space can be considered as a metric space. So this closed interval is also a metric space. If inside this metric space, we are going to consider an open sphere with center again at 1 and radius is 1/2. Okay, so this will be 1 minus 1/2 and 1 plus 1/2, which is 1/2, 3/2. So is this the open sphere that we are looking for? No, because on this metric space, so this is our metric space 1 to 2, so this is our metric space, but if we consider this open interval, so this is 1/2, 3/2, this is the set of all points from 1/2 to 3/2. So this is not an open sphere because the points from 1/2 to 1, these are the points which lie outside our metric space. They don't belong to the metric space. Whereas an open sphere is a set which contains all the points which belong to the metric space. Okay, so we will consider only those points from in this interval which belong to our metric space this. Okay, so these points will be 1, 2, 3 by 2, including 1. Okay, so this will be our sphere with radius 1 by 2 and center 1 for this metric space. So now let us consider examples of open spheres in other metric spaces. So now let us consider the metric space which is our Cartesian coordinate plane, which is R2. So open sphere in x equals R2. So in this metric space, so we are considering R2 as metric space. So with a point suppose capital X0 with coordinates X0, Y0, because in R2 any point will have basically two coordinates, X coordinate and Y coordinate. Okay, so it will be an ordered pair. R be any positive real number, then the metric on R2 is, you know that metric on R2 is D of suppose X and X0 is simply, so X be any point with coordinates X comma Y. So this distance function will be basically the distance between these two points, X minus X0 square plus Y minus Y0 square whole square. Okay, so now an open sphere inside this metric space will be sphere with radius R centered at capital X0. So this will be equal to the set of all points capital X belonging to R2 such that the distance from X to X0 is less than R. So this implies, so this is the set of all capital X belonging to R square, and this distance is this thing, so X minus X0 whole squared plus Y minus Y0 squared square root is less than R. So the set of points satisfying this condition will be our open sphere. Okay, so inside our xy plane, so this is x axis, this is y. Suppose this is our x0 point with coordinates x0, y0. Okay, now the set of all the points which satisfy this inequality, as you can see, is basically an open circle, okay, with radius r. So this is our radius r. So this circle, so this circle will be our open sphere. Now here this is open circle because here we have less than r. Okay, x0 minus x0 square plus y minus y0 whole square square root is less than r. Less than r means we have all the points which are at a distance less than r from x0. So only the points inside this circle. So that is why it is an open circle. So an open sphere inside R2 is an open circle. So now let us consider an open sphere inside the discrete metric space. So open sphere in the discrete metric space. Okay. As we discussed in our previous lecture, that a discrete metric space is basically a metric space which has a metric D of xy, which is 0 if x is equal to y and 1 if x is not equal to y. Okay, so a metric space with this metric is called a discrete metric space. So now we will consider an open sphere inside this metric space. So let again x0 be a point inside this metric space, suppose metric space X, and R be a positive real number. Okay, now an open sphere with radius R centered at X naught will be equal to, by definition, the set of all X belonging to the metric space psi that the distance of X from X naught is less than R. So by definition, this is an open sphere. Okay, so now we are considering different cases of R over here. So case one, when R is greater than 1. Okay, suppose when R is greater than 1, what will be the open sphere in this case? So now the open sphere will be equal to, okay, now R is any number greater than 1, and now we are taking the distance less than that number. Okay, less than that number means that the distance can either be 0 or 1. It means now d of x naught is either 0 or 1. Okay, so it means in open sphere we are taking all those points whose distance from x naught is either 0 or 1. So it means we are taking the whole of this discrete metric space. So this set of points is equal to the whole discrete metric space. Okay, so in discrete metric space, if R is greater than 1, then an open sphere will be basically the whole metric space. Now we are considering the case 2, when R is equal to 1, and then case 3, when R is less than 1. So now let us consider the case 2. So case 2, when R is equal to 1. Okay, so now in this case, the open sphere with radius R centered at X naught will be equal to the set of all X belonging to X psi that the distance of X from X naught is less than 1. So from here we can see that the distance is less than 1 means that the distance is 0. Okay, so the set of all X belonging to X whose distance from X naught is 0. So all the points, the set of all those points whose distance from X naught is 0, so it will be just X naught itself, because the distance of a point from itself is 0. Okay, so it means this set is the set with value X naught, which is a singleton set. So when R is 1, then the open sphere inside the discrete metric space is just a set with only a single value, which is X naught, which is the center of the sphere. Now third case, so when R is less than 1. So R is less than 1 means, now again we have this case that distance is 0. So this is the same as this one. So SR of X naught, so this is the same, the set of all X belonging to X, so the d of X naught is less than 1, which is again the same, the set with value X naught. So if we are considering a point X naught in discrete metric space, and we are going to consider an open sphere centered at that point X naught, then that open sphere will either be the whole discrete metric space, or it will be a set with only one value, which is X naught, which is also the center of the sphere. So for example, so if inside discrete metric space, again suppose if X is our discrete metric space, and if you consider X naught is suppose 1 and radius is suppose 2. So now radius is greater than 1. So in this case, the open sphere will be the whole metric space. So now open sphere or open sphere with radius 2 centered at 1 is the whole metric space, which is discrete metric space. And if x naught is 1, but if r is suppose equal to 1, so in this case the open sphere with radius 1 and center 1, so in this case it will be just the set with only the center point 1. The same is the case for any radius which is less than 1. So we have seen that open sphere inside the real line is just an open interval, and an open sphere inside the coordinate plane is an open circle, and an open sphere inside the discrete metric space is either the whole discrete metric space or the set with only a single point of the metric space, which is the center of the sphere. So now let us define a closed sphere or closed ball inside a metric space. So again, let XD, a metric space with a metric D, be a metric space and X naught belong to X and R be any positive real number, then a closed sphere or closed ball with center X naught and radius R is defined as the set of all those points of the metric space X whose distance from X naught is less than or equal to R. Less than or equal to. Now we have equal as well in closed sphere. Okay, when the distance is less than or equal to R. A sphere with radius R and center at X naught. For a closed interval, we use square brackets. So for open sphere we used parentheses, but for closed sphere we will use square brackets. So this is this or and a closed ball with center X naught and radius R. So again square brackets. So this is basically the set of all X belonging to the metric space whose distance from X naught is less than or equal to R. So this is the definition of a closed sphere or closed ball. So now let us consider some examples of closed spheres or closed balls. So again, first we consider our metric space, usual metric space, which is the set of real numbers or the real line. So inside the real line, a closed sphere is just a closed interval. And similarly, in R2, a closed sphere is just a closed circle. So, a closed sphere in X is equal to R, the real line, is a closed interval. And similarly, a closed sphere in X is equal to R2, which is XY plane or the coordinate plane. A closed circle. So now we will take into consideration the boundary of the circle as well. So in today's lecture, we talked about open spheres and closed spheres inside metric spaces. And we illustrated the concepts with examples from different metric spaces. So that's it for now. See you in the next lecture.